Hello, Namaste in Seal Beach Center for Spiritual Living. It's great to be here again for another week of our video series. My name is Reverend Bobbi. I'm the Senior Minister and Spiritual Director of Namaste in Seal Beach Center for Spiritual Living, and I'm here with the amazing Rev John.
Thank you, Rev Bobbi. And yes, we're in this continuing conversation about values and how they impact the evolution and growth of our community. And so it's been exciting so far.
It has, huh? We're going to be talking about an even more exciting topic that you may think isn't very exciting. We're going to talk about accountability and safety. Don't pause the video. Because what we're about to talk about is really integral to how we move forward as a community. All of us, every one of us, every person that watches this video. So one of the things we wanted to talk about today is with respect to accountability and safety is standards and having standards in the community for our leadership, having standards in the community for practitioners, for any person that walks into that into our community. In order to have accountability and safety, we have to have some standards in place. And we've been talking about this for some time. And part of that is being willing to emotionally grow, being willing to say that in order for us to perform at a particular level, performance isn't about success. It's about spiritual growth. It's about building a community that is community-centric, not minister-centric, where the standard isn't just placed on the minister, but we all accept that in mutual accountability.
You know, and we often talk about accountability. We think of standards of structure, like board responsibilities, volunteerism,
but we'd like to,
we'd like to take this a little deeper in terms of your own spiritual growth and development. What does accountability mean there?
And if I'm not willing to, I know a lot of folks come into communities and their, you know, connection is number one, and it should be, because to grow in a community, you have to have connection, but it doesn't go anywhere from there. In fact, what happens is that people have expectations of how a community should be or shouldn't be. And standards give a place for people to understand, well, how safe is this? Or what does safety really look like? What's accountability? And for me, when I think about accountability for myself, I think about being in integrity with what I choose to do, how I act. Every decision I make as a minister and community has to be based on my own personal integrity. How about you, John?
Well, and I agree with that, and the willingness to have a dialogue and discussion about falling short of what we say we're going to do or who we are choosing to be. And so if we're out of integrity there, having a willingness to listen to feedback that we perhaps aren't being up to our own standards that we're espousing to other people.
Right. And so, for example, if there's something that I feel that is not happening in integrity in the community, it's important that I'm in direct and honest and or clear about what it is that I'm really trying to accomplish. And when I'm not, then I might be doing things like being passive aggressive, or I'm afraid to say what I really feel or think, because I don't want to anger people or upset people or make people uncomfortable. But the point of it, and maybe sometimes in this role, you kind of get that freedom to do it. But I don't necessarily believe that, John. I think sometimes leaders are just as afraid as everyone else, sometimes more, because you're so in the middle of it all.
Well, in this iteration of what we're trying to create, you know, the tendency in the past has been to avoid discomfort.
Yeah.
And that is not being accountable to the evolutionary process, to the creative process, as we espouse it in the science of mind teaching.
Right.
We have to be willing to look at those things that perhaps we're afraid to look at.
I was thinking really about the fact that when I think about my own personal integrity, it really means that you can count on me. It means that there's something about what I'm doing that what I say I'm going to do, I do, or at least communicate to you that I can't, or something's changed, commitment change, program change, whatever it might be. But to be in integrity with that, that you can count on me, that I'm going to back you up as part of a team. And so I'm going to tell a little quick story about my niece came to me. She plays university level volleyball. And I went and watched her last Friday. And I was watching her team, and they've got some great talent on the team, but they don't play as a team. I noticed that it was more about individual play as a team, and they weren't working together to accomplish or at least be their best for each other. And she was asking me, you know, what do I think? Because she was very frustrated. And I said, you know what it looks like? It looks like that you don't count on one another. It looks like that you don't have each other's backs as a team. And I imagine that if you worked or started from that place, that winning would come much easier because you would be playing together. I see other teams and I can definitely tell that they back one another up. In our community, it's the same way. I want to be there and be, I want to back people up. I want to be on their, be there. I want to back them up. I want them to know they can count on me and I can count on them, and that we're doing this together. And that's a version of accountability that we don't always consider.
Well, and I love that story because it really nails the issue of, you know, what does it take to really be able to do that? Well, it takes practice, for one, of being able to know what you can count on someone else for, but also what you're willing to put yourself in, what situation you're willing to put yourself in. And that requires a commitment to your spiritual practice, to the concept of discipline. Of, and people hate the word discipline because it's a, you know, it's maybe what they thought of a punishment. But instead, if we look at the root of that as being a disciple, of studying at the feet of your own higher self, of your greater evolutionary purpose. And so we need to be able to practice that, to know for ourselves where integrity is, what we can count on from ourselves to be in integrity. And that takes practice.
So what we're doing within this, creating this new community, is looking at everything and asking ourselves, what's the standard that we want? And the standard at minimum has to be the standard set in some cases by home office, which I think some of those standards are fantastic. It's just a basic standard. And or what's the standard we want for each other? And we get to do that.
John, we get to do that. We
John, you have a little exercise you wanted to.
Well, I do. So here's what I'd invite you to consider is making a list of someone important or a person that's important in your life, and make a list of three things that they can count on you to do or to be. And then you make a list of what you're willing to say to them that you can count on me to do or be that. Then the fun part comes, because then you can compare your lists and have a great conversation about accountability. Oh, I didn't know you counted on me to do that, Reverend Bobbi.
You like these videos. Surprises, right? But that's okay. I think it's interesting to get that kind of feedback. Am I willing to actually ask for that kind of feedback from someone to say, what can you count on me for? And here's what I can count on you for. Those are deep, rich, and emotionally uncomfortable conversations that build our stamina and our ability to be in these kinds of conversations, because that's what we're known for.
And to be more authentic than you ever dreamed possible. Mm.
Well, John, this was another great short conversation. I really appreciate you and love when we do this. So thanks for being part of this.
Thanks, Reverend Bobbi. I look forward to this all the time.
Great.
Be well.
So next week, we have one last video. We're going to do a little recap on this whole unification and collaboration that we've been doing and what we've walked through. So join us next week. Thanks for being here today.